I'm standing in front of a very, very fine and very precious organ. Yes, this is the organ that was in Buckingham Palace, London. It now lives in Saarbrücken, and the organist on the bench is Bernhard Leonardi, and who has just improvised on God Save the Queen. So appropriate. Bernhard, tell us, why is this organ here and not in England?
This organ has made quite an odyssey of different places. So the original part of this instrument was built in the middle of the 18th century. The organ builder was Samuel Green. Mm-hmm. And at this time, Samuel Green was the organ builder of the king himself. Mm. And so it was originally constructed for the private chapel first of Windsor Castle. So Windsor Castle was in this time the living center of the royal family. And in this time it was constructed very little organ positive. And this very little instrument is here, the first manual. Mm. So this first manual is in the middle of the 18th century. So you can think Handel was dead in this time. So perhaps Handel has made a little bit the ideas of this new organ. And his the next one who was the music master of the royal family was the youngest son of Johann Sebastian Bach. John Christian Bach. Mm. So it was the youngest son, the youngest child of Johann Sebastian Bach, child number 19, if you count it very exactly. So, and he was the music master of the royal family and the music master of this instrument. Mm. And he was the professor for flute for the whole royal family. And perhaps you have here wonderful flutes in it. Because it's of this idea that the flutes must be very good here. You have a very high flute, which is quite wonderful. As a wonderful, wonderful sound here. So, and the story of the instrument is very interesting too, because in this time there was a very a young child going to Europe to learn all was possible for him. It was the young Mozart. Mm-hmm. And the young Mozart came to John Christian Bach to learn from him all details. And he studied with him in London. Not only 1 hour, for a long time he studied nearly 1 year with him. Mm-hmm. And in this time the history says that Mozart was better in organ playing than in piano playing. So you can imagine that he, these keys are not original one, but the pipes are original one. So you can imagine that it sounds like Mozart a little bit in this time, mm-hmm. when he played this organ too. So, and after the time, the royal family decided to go to London, to the new industry metropole, industry city. Mm-hmm. Then all was rebuilt in the new house of Buckingham Palace. But they decided not to rebuild an organ. An organ, because I say this organ was so beautiful, because of this they will take it with them. And so this organ was added another little organ of the organ builder Gray. Mm-hmm. And in this time the best friends of the royal family of Queen Victoria and Prince Albert. Mm. Prince Albert was a very good organ player too.
I did not know that. Was he really?
Yes. He came from the east of Germany.
Yes, yes. And yeah.
There is one picture, Mendelssohn in the behind, being like this, and Queen Victoria singing, and Prince Albert playing the organ here. Oh. So, and in this time, there were romantic stops added, yes. As you can hear, like this. It sounds a little bit like an English men's choir in a romantic idea.
Yes, very serious.
Yes. So in a very smooth and romantic sound. In this time, this swell was added.
Right.
And it was added...
When it was in the palace.
It was in the palace, yes. Right. It was put in the new private chapel. First it was a winter garden. I think in Germany it's a conservatory.
Yes.
And then this was rebuilt as a royal chapel. So then this chapel, this organ played for years and for decades and for a very long time.
Yes.
All weddings and all confessions and things were made with the sounds of these organ too. And even in 1926, when the Queen was... The baptism of the Queen was made with the sound of the organ.
Oh,
I think she will not remember it, but,
no.
but I think the organ was, the organ sound was there. And so it's a very interesting story. And then in the war, the organ was, or the royal chapel was destroyed in the war. And you can see in some pictures Churchill and the Queen being on the ruins of this chapel, and in a sort of English humor, the Queen said, "It's wonderful. Now I can see the east end of the palace now." But the only thing was there was the organ, and now they decided to not to rebuild this ruin as a chapel. Now it's the Queen's Gallery, the modern gallery, the Gallery for Modern Art, there in Buckingham Palace, and they gave the organ to the Holy Trinity Church of London. And now it's a very amazing story. The organ is with the fighter against the Nazis. It was Dietrich Bonhoeffer was in London there, and he made his famous homily, preaches against the Nazi there. With the organ, so it's a very interesting story. And after this, it was given to a college, and this college decided it was in a wonderful room like this, and it was decided to make this room more big, and for this the organ was too small, and we had the opportunity to. To buy it here with this very special history, and it's now a touristic attraction for the city here because we have so many interesting composers played on this instrument, and even it sounds wonderful if you have, for example, this royal trumpets, original ones. Royal sound, and you have this sound of English organ music. If you take all the ground registers of the organ, you have really an English sound in it. It's a wonderful singing instrument. It sings like a choir.
Yes.
And but you have some brightness in it because you have this original. Very little stops, and there you have a very brilliant Baroque organ. And you can add this trumpet of the swell, for example, here. If you shut the swell, you have in this very little organ a little bit the idea of a French romantic instrument too. It sounds really very interesting. A little bit in this idea, and here you have, for example, oboe, which is not made as a trumpet stop. It is made as a ground stop. And you have this this kind of string sound too in a very little organ. So you can make with this very little instrument nearly all sorts of music too.
You can make lots of sounds. Yeah. Now, is the case, is this original?
The case, originally in Buckingham Palace, it had another case. So it was in the front of the chapel. This case is from the middle of 19th century. Mm-hmm. So they made it, but it's original, the colors too. This green color looking a little bit like a Christmas tree is completely original, and here you have this original golden things. It's really gold.
Gold leaf.
Gold, yes.
Oh, wow.
Leaf. So, and even this this bright blue is original. And there you have the flags on the other, on the both sides of the royal of Scottish royal family and the original royal family. It was always like this.
So Prince Albert could have played this organ.
Yes.
He would have.
Yes,
Johann Christoph Bach.
And Mendelssohn and Mozart.
Oh, it's just, it's incredible. It makes you feel so humbled, doesn't it?
So we are very proud to have this instrument here.
And how did you find it? How did you?
It was really something which happens one time alive.
Yes.
So I was invited from Eton College.
Uh-huh.
We had here as a concert here in our town, the Eton College Choir.
Yeah.
And I was invited to discover the organs of Eton College.
Mm.
And the professor of Eton College told me, we spoke a little bit about organ music and the little organ world. And he told me, in this moment we have a very interesting instrument, and it was sold, but the man who tried to collect it, when he stand before the organ, he saw that it was too big for him.
Yeah.
He has not good
height.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so the works in this chapel had begun to reconstruct this chapel, and the organ was still there. And we have been for holidays there, and we decided in one moment to take it.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Yes.
Tell us about the building that it's in. How old is this building?
Yes, this is the oldest building nearly of our country. It's from the 12th century.
Of Germany?
Not of Germany, of our Saarland, of our region here.
Our county, okay.
Of our county, yes. And it's a very interesting building because it's on the way, on the pilgrim's way to Santiago de Compostela.
Mm-hmm.
And you have both parts of this building. So here in this part, you had a hospital. So this was always a hospital to have care for the people. And there on the other side, there was the holy part of the church with the masses and the services and all these
things.
Was
it always open like that? It was always
open? Yes, it was always open.
So people could be sick here?
And the celebration, they thought that the celebration of a holy mass could help them to be in a good health very soon. And so you have two doors. This is the door to the town, and this is the door to the, what's the name, cemetery?
Oh.
Yes, so two doors here in this church. And it's a very interesting story too, that this head of a woman there, in the high there.
Oh yeah.
It's the one of the first pictures of the Holy Elizabeth. So this is one of the first chapels built as a patronage of the new Holy Elizabeth.
Wow.
Here. So it's a very famous famous chapel, and it's today still it belongs to a youth hospital.
Mm.
And so the help of the people is now for 800 years.
Right, so they still use it as a chapel.
Yeah. Hmm? Yes, they use it as a chapel, but they use it, it's used by a church, it's used for birthdays too, it's used for concerts, so we have a very various things we can do here.
Now, you opened the organ about 2 years ago?
Yes.
I was here for that. It was a great concert. It was absolutely packed, wasn't it? I sat right at the back there.
Yes, it sounded.
And what did they do before they had the Buckingham Palace organ? They had nothing in here?
No, there was... this chapel was forgot, and it was not in... it was not very well made like this, so we renewed the whole building, and after this we added this organ, and now it's... something special on the Pilgrim's Way. We give many concerts here, and it's a little bit private atmosphere.
Yes.
It's a little bit like in Buckingham Palace. You can speak to the people,
yes.
You can place a little thing, and then you can tell the story of the instrument. And this is something people can learn a lot of organ music, and to understand organ music is very important that you help a little bit in saying something.
Bernhard, thank you so much for showing us both these organs. I've thoroughly enjoyed this. I really have. And to end up here with this special jewel of an instrument,
yes,
it's been really enlightening. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. And sorry for not speaking very correct, but I hope I can speak to the hearts of the people.
Thank you. You have done.
Yes,
thank you.
Thank you.